Test match debut, obviously first test match I did not play. I was there as a second keeper. A test match debut happened by accident. You know, the regular keeper Ajay Ratra got injured a day before a test match. And I was told that, you know, you might play, but the chances are very less because I think he should be fit before the game starts. Okay, so I was giving throwdowns to VVS Lakshman. And just before going for a toss, Saurav Ganguly came in and said that you are playing today. So I was like, I didn't know how to react. You know, when you, the first dream of a cricketer is to play for India, play test cricket. And here I was, you know, on the verge of living my dream, making a debut for Indian test team. But I think that was a blessing in disguise for me because, you know, I had no time to think about it. You know, usually before a game, even now when I play, when we all play, we used to get, we do get sleepless night. You know, we get nervous before a game start, but everything settles once you enter the field. But still, I think, you know, so it happened. Test debut went really well. Second test match, we were playing in Headingley where, you know, we won the test match. So that India had won a test match there after 18 or 20 years. So I was fortunate enough to be part of it. Then the Pakistan tour, Australia tour, everything, you know, everything was going really well for me. So at 17, 18, you just live your life, you know. I mean, that's something which is living a life of a superstar. No one from Gujarat had ever played test cricket. The last person had played was in 1957. And then I was the one there playing test cricket without playing for Gujarat. I had just played under-19 India, India A, and straight into the test match. Then came a couple of series didn't go well for me. I was dropped as usual. I mean, that's how it is. You know, when you're a cricketer, some you have to keep performing and to perform for a longer time. That's a biggest challenge because we are in a field where our job has been, you know, questioned or praised by everyone in India. Where if you have a job somewhere else and if you make a mistake, no one would not even notice sometimes. But when you are a cricketer, when you make a mistake, everyone has an opinion. Everyone would, you know, tell you that, you know, you've done something which is like a crime. You know, if you drop a catch, just imagine someone drops a catch tomorrow India-Pakistan game, what happens to him? So that's the level of pressure. You know, sometimes, you know, cricketers, they say that cricketers have a rosy life. I just wanted to, you know, tell you that, you know, how easy or how difficult it is for everyone. So I got dropped at the age of 20, where most of sportsmen or a business or, you know, they come out of the college, they start their life. Here I was branded that my life is over at 20. You know, they said, it's done. You've played at 17, 20, your life is over. You cannot play anymore. That's it. You've done. You cannot make a comeback. So my confidence was so shattered that I used to find, you know, even when you still play cricket, right? There is club cricket, there is state cricket, there is a lot of other cricket. And when you get dropped, the common question which came to me was, do you still play cricket? I was like, yeah, I still play cricket. But there was no confidence in me because I got dropped. I read a lot of negative things about me which got into my mind. And when I got dropped and played first club game, where I thought there were 22 fielders in the offside, 22 fielders in the leg side, and there is no gap on the ground at all. I will not be able to score any run. I was scared of catching a tennis ball. So it's like a student is scared of a pen. So that's how bad my mindset was. I could not, if someone would throw a ball to me, I used to get scared. So I went and told my dad that I'll have to start pursuing my studies because at 17 I was picked for India. I've studied only till 11th. I haven't studied after that. So he's like, I don't think I'll allow you to do that. You know, there is, you have to find what you were at 17. There were not many people, or there were only 4 or 5 have, you know, gone on to represent India at 16 and 17. So there has to be something special in you. And that's where the family's role comes into play. So my parents told me that, you know, you go out there, practice, you do whatever you want to do it. There are no expectations from us. You enjoy what you are doing. So that's how I started getting into the practicing mode again. Still, there was a goal in my mind that I want to play for India again. And to do that, I obviously know that, you know, when you want to play for India again, there's a lot of hard work which was needed to be done. So I used to go there, go to the ground, you know, ask coaches to hit catches, give me a lot of throwdowns, set a bowling machine and bat for like hours. And still, there were a lot of guys who used to tell, you know, यार ये क्यों आ जाता है सुबह सुबह हमारे लिए विकेट बनानी पड़ती है इसके लिए थ्रो डाउन्स करने पड़ते हैं बट कि ये कभी इंडिया के लिए तो कभी खेल पाएगा नहीं अभी बट यू नो ऑल दोज थिंग्स आई हैव हर्ड न्यूमरस टाइम बट ओनली थिंग विच आई पर्सनली फेल्ट थ्रू आउट माई करियर इज सेल्फ बिलीफ आई थिंक इफ यू बिलीव दैट यू कैन डू इट आई एम श्योर नो वन कैन स्टॉप यू फ्रॉम यू नो अचीविंग वॉट यू रियली वॉन्ट टू अचीव So I went to, from India, I went to the Gujarat cricket, played first class, played Ranji Trophy. So you know how most of the Gujaratis are. You know, we just wanted to hang in there. Sports wasn't there in our team naturally because no one had played for India. We just playing for the sake of it. You know, everyone is playing, every state is playing, so we had to play. And the thinking was, batsman's thinking was, I want to get 30 runs so that my next game is confirmed. And the bowler's thinking was, if I get one wicket or two wicket, I'll be able to play next match. And I was 20 and I was captaining the side. And my mindset was completely different. I wanted to, you know, build a side. I wanted to win Ranji Trophy. That's another dream of a player, to win Ranji Trophy. And to win for Gujarat was something which no one could ever think of, that Gujarat will ever win Ranji Trophy then in 2005-06. So I had to change the mindset of players and how do I do it. I know the skill-wise we were not the greatest of the team, but just to, you know, tell every player that we are good enough, we can beat, there's something called winning, which was never there in anyone's mind. And even when you are playing with a lot of these guys, that came out of my mind as well. Because, you know, no one was there to play. No one was there to playing to win. And to change that mindset, I had to do a lot of one-on-one meeting. I've been leading the side for 10 years now. So I had to do a lot of one-on-one meetings and tell every player that, you know, there's something called century. There's something called five wicket. And try and do it once and see how happy you get. So then, though I got my first 100 after 150 one-day games, but still, you know, I had to tell them that, you know, we have to think in that way. So we started winning, we started, you know, getting recognitions. I played for India for a couple of one-days after that and then got dropped again. But every morning, why was I going to the ground? And every morning, why was I hitting so many balls? Why was I doing this? Because I enjoyed doing it. Now, coming back to making a test comeback after 8 years, you know, there's another record, the youngest wicketkeeper, and there's another record that, you know, no one has made a comeback after 8 years. So there are two different big records in my life. Yeah, so I made a test comeback after 8 years. How did that happen? See, honestly speaking, I didn't know how did that happen. The only thing which I was doing was performing at the domestic level, just doing what I was supposed to do, is keep performing. And, you know, even before in those 8 years, there were chances came that, you know, I felt, or a lot of guys felt, that I should have been selected. There was one incident where I had scored 800 runs in 8 games and someone else had scored 300 runs in 8 games. But he got picked. So I called up selector and I asked him, why? I mean, I think I have all the rights of asking him. He's like, we feel that your cricket is over. You're a Gujarati, why don't you start doing a business? So this was at age of 26. And I was like, this was the last word which I wanted to hear from a selector. So I told him, I obviously didn't told him politely. I told him, see, I'll go back and I'll put you in a situation where you will have to select me. I don't know how that came in. I still remember that I've told him that. And the next Ranji Trophy season, I had scored 800 runs in 8 games. That season, I had scored 1,000 runs in 6 games. That I made a comeback, and after 8 years, I felt like, you know, I wasn't expecting it, because I was already told that, you know, boss, your cricket is over. I wasn't expecting it to get picked. But somehow, you know, before the season started, RP Singh, who obviously another player who plays for India, he plays for Gujarat. So I was telling him that, boss, it looks like that, you know, I think I will make a comeback this season. There are a lot of test matches and I think I will make a comeback. So he's like, yeah, let's hope. He was my teammate and he was also knowing that I will not. But somehow it happened only because I'd worked so hard throughout my phase of 8 years where, you know, I got results. So I think the clear message from my life is, you know, keep working hard, keep believing. I think belief is something which is, I think, a very, very big word in terms of, you know, achieving success. After doing all those things, Gujarat have won the Ranji Trophy as well this year. So, I mean, Gujarat winning Ranji Trophy, Gujarat beating Mumbai, that is like probably the unheard thing ever. And the only time we beat them is Ranji Trophy final. You know, we've played against them since so many years, and the only time we beat them is Ranji Trophy final. There is a way, the time is running out. I'll just tell you a simple story how, you know, when Mumbai team used to come to Gujarat to play a Ranji Trophy game, it is obviously a 4-day game, but they would book the tickets on third day evening. They would come there with the return ticket of a third day evening, knowing that they will beat Gujarat whatever happens. And Gujarat team used to go to Mumbai playing Ranji Trophy, getting a 1 empty bag that 4th day fashion street se shopping karenge. That's what our mindset was. And from there to win Ranji Trophy, I'm talking about us, but I think that's probably the biggest achievement I feel has been so far in my cricketing career. Because, and why did that happen? Again, before a season started, there were 8 league games, but we've always talked about is 11 games. 8 plus quarterfinal, semifinal, final. We've never made a goal of playing just 8 games. I've asked everyone to make a goal, how many runs or how many wickets you want to take in after 11 games, not 8 games. That was even before season started. So if you have a goal, if you know that, you know, which direction to go, you can always achieve it. Thank you very much. I hope it was good. Thanks.